If you own a condo or are thinking about buying a condo, I want you to really pay attention to this because there's some absolutely mind-shattering data that just came out today. So we all know that COVID is changing the way people want to live. They don't like feeling like somebody's on top of them, especially with having to be crammed in their houses. They want to make sure that they feel like they have not only some health safety, but also have some room, some space to be able to live. And some super crazy numbers came out today, and I want to break them down for you. Three counties were analyzed particularly, and each one of these counties has a completely different demographic basis. So it gave us a very, very smooth data set. So listings, meaning the number of homes that are available on the market, were compared from the beginning of the year of 2020 till there where they sat in October of 2020. And now listings for condos compared to listings for single family homes have gone up 400% in San Francisco County. That means that what normally the amount of listings that come on the market when compared as an even ratio of one condo to one single family home, now four condos are hitting the market for every single family home in San Francisco County. A 400% increase from what it was pre-COVID. LA County saw the similar numbers, a 200% increase in the number of condos hitting the market currently from the beginning of the year. And finally, in Charlotte, 320% increase in the amount of condos hitting the market from just a year ago. Now, what does that show? People are getting out of their condos and wanting to move to more space. Well, what happens when you have a large amount of inventory of a particular type of home hitting the market? Prices are gonna come down, right? That's just naturally. So as we've seen single family homes inventory be at the historically the lowest levels we've ever seen since this data has been recorded over the last 50 years, we're seeing a completely different trend in condos. If you're already kind of concerned like, maybe I wanna list my condo for sale, it's not too late. You definitely wanna look at doing that because the more and more that we move towards into next year, we're gonna see more and more of this inventory hit the market. The other thing that is very important to note is the difference. The price change from January of 2020 to currently now in December of 2020 on each one of these data sets, meaning condos in San Francisco from the beginning of the year to right now have dropped 1% in price, whereas single family homes gone up 13%. Now, normally, just to give you guys an idea, condos and single family homes, they are very, very, very close. You usually see maybe 80% of the movement in a single family home in a condo, meaning if single family homes go up 10% in value, condos will go up about 8%. Look at that. That one went up 13%. Condos dropped. They're cheaper than they were at the beginning of the year. You look in LA County, condos went up 8% versus single family homes, 25% in the amount surveyed. 25% appreciation from January 1st of 2020 until right now on single family homes in LA County versus condos only went up 8%. And lastly, in Charlotte, North Carolina, you saw a negative 2% for condo appreciation, whereas single family homes, 18%. Okay, so think about that. As we know, and the real estate market is driven simply by supply and demand. So if you know that we can see the data story tell us before the full picture really hits the news, if you're looking to buy a condo or you're looking to sell your condo potentially and move to a single family home, now is the time to reconsider if you're looking at buying a condo and get into looking at a single family, because we're gonna continue to see this dramatic data set shift, right? With people wanting to get out of their condos, and the more condos that hit the market, there's gonna not be enough demand to meet the supply of those condos hitting the market. Whereas there's not gonna be nearly enough supply in single family homes meeting the demand for people wanting to buy single family homes. If you got a condo, now is the time to definitely sell if you are planning on moving in the near future. And if you were considering potentially buying a condo, if it isn't gonna be a home for, call it 10 years or more, I would strongly look at seeing if there maybe is a suburb right outside of a metro area that you can get into a single family home is gonna be a far better investment.